On Docker, there was some confusing yesterday about the persistence in volumes, and I'm just going to show what you can do. And there are data that is saved in the volume when you create it. So in this case, I'm going to do a Docker run and IT, and I'll just write Ubuntu and bin bash. You can actually, it works without even writing bin bash, I've realized. So now I have my Ubuntu Docker container, which I'm inside. I'll do an apt update, and I'm actually going to install Nano instead of Vim. But so you can see that I'm in the root of this one, and I'm logged in as root. So I'll write Nano hello text. And I'll save this file. We can now see that, yeah, we do have a file here called hello.txt. And we can see this is me inside a Docker container. So I've done some changes. I've installed Nano, for example, and I have also created a text file, and I'm inside the Docker container. I exit this one, and now I'm on my Mac again in my terminal. So I'll write Docker container, sorry, ls. Now running containers. I'll put on dash a, and then I can see all of them, so that I can see that, okay, I do have one that exited it 22 seconds ago, created 1 minute ago, and I pruned my all containers before this video. So, and there is a one image Ubuntu, and the command was bin bash, and now the text is too big, but you can see that the name, make this a little bit smaller, and then I'll clear, and it still is, do like this. You can see here the name is Sen Weskoff, that's the name, and I just let Docker automatically assign a name. So I did a Docker container, I was inside that, did something, and then I exited. How can I access that data again? Because if I do run, let's do this, I run a new container, I want my Ubuntu like this. I'll just discard the bin bash, and I can show that it works. Okay, so now I'm yet in another Ubuntu container. Let's look at this one. Oh, I can't see the hello text file. Try to run Nano. Oh, it doesn't work. That means that I'm most likely running in a new container, which is exactly what I was doing. So let's list the containers, and you can see here that there are now two containers here. One which exited 14 seconds ago, and then one other a minute ago. And this last one with objective Corona, Coronana. Yeah, and then we have the Sen Weskoff. You can see that they contain ID and the names. But I did some fancy stuff in this container. I would like to access that one. Is that possible? Yes, it is. Docker start. And then I can write A as in attach. Can use like this as well. A is easier. I want it to be interactive. That means that I want to interact with the container. That means in the terminal. And the name. Voila! Now it's running. Let's poke around. I can see that I have my hello text file here. let's look inside it. This is me inside the docking container. Great. And my nano, oh, it works. Great. And then I exit and we can see that we now have two containers. There is also a possibility of naming your container when you start it. So for instance, if you would like to start a node red, running node red under Docker. I showed this earlier. So I'm just going to copy paste this. And what this is doing is that it's actually creating a, if we look at this code, this is Docker run IT, that means it will be interactive. The P is for ports. This is a web service, a web server running, so it needs to have ports opened, otherwise you won't be able to interact with it. And the V flag is the volume flag. What this is doing is creating a volume called node red data. So this is a persistent volume that is created when you do this. So it's sort of a creating a new hard disk or like a virtual drive within Docker. That is mapped to the data folder inside the Docker container. And then you have the flag name, which is called my node red. And this is the Docker Hub repository, like the image which you're using that we talked about in the video yesterday. But let's just run this exactly as it is. And we're up running. So we can just check that it is working. And I guess it should be working. Yes, it does. I recently installed some Datacake nodes. Oh, and they are still there. Even though I did delete the image, because this is now, all the data is stored in the Docker volume called Node Red. So that's one way of doing it. And I can run several Node-RED instances on my local computer. Just fire up more Docker containers. Just be aware that you cannot have the same name on them. And obviously you need to change the ports. So if you have your first Node-RED instance and 8080, you might have the second and 8081 and so on. But it's no problem of running several of these things on your computer. And it might be some problems if they share all the same data, obviously. So that's about it.